Hello everyone. In this video, I will teach you how you can expand your marketing reach by using web push notifications. You can use it to gather new subscribers, to promote a specific product, anything that's going on your website, updates, and well, this will change the game as you can reach people who didn't subscribe to your newsletter. Stay tuned. Alright, so now we are logged in GetResponse, and what we need to do to access web push notifications is to go to Tools on the top left and click Web Push Notifications. Here you can see already I have my website added, and we will do the same for you. You simply click to Add Site, add a name, my website, and this name is only for you, nobody else will see that. On the site information, you will add your URL. This is my URL here. And then you can upload an icon, and which I recommend because, well, your prompt will just look better and you will see how. Well, so once you have that, you simply need to click Add Site and Continue. So this part is not complicated at all. You are now presented with step two. And well, this is the complicated part, let's call it. And you have a tracking code. Let's go step by step. So tracking code first. And we will install this tracking code. We will click to copy the code, and this code has to be installed on the head of your page. Let's now go to WordPress. So WordPress is the platform that we are using to demonstrate, but if you have any other platform, as long as you have access to the head of the page, you are good to go. And well, if you have WordPress like me, you are a lucky one because you can just copy. So we go to Appearance, Theme File Editor, and we will find the header right here, theme header. And well, the head starts right here and it finishes right here. So we will paste the code right before the end, right here. And you simply click update file. All right, so this step is completed. Nothing else to do here. Let's now go back. And then you have a service worker file. Well, this is something else a bit more advanced, but it's something that you need to place on your cPanel, and I will show you how you can do that as well. Simply click to download. So I already did that, so I'm not clicking once again. And then select the place where you want the file to be downloaded to. And well, once you do that, you simply go to your cPanel, your database, wherever you have this information. I recommend that you contact a web developer. They will know how to direct you. If you are familiar, if you have something similar like me, you will know exactly where to go as well. So in my case, you would simply go to File Manager, Public HTML, and here is where you want to drag and drop the file. And I already have the file here. It's exactly this one. You need to drag and drop or simply upload the file. If you click to upload, you will be presented with something like this. You will select the file, open, and then it will be uploaded. You would then see the file as we do right here. And well, let's assume that's already done. And then we simply have to go back to GetResponse. Let's simply go back. And well, you would click finish. As I don't want to save that, I will just click back to site information and I will click cancel. But you would click finish and you would go forward. I will also delete this to not cause any confusion with my other one. There is no limit on how many websites you can add here. I only deleted because I was using exactly the same website. And well, I will click here. And you, as you will be following the next step, you need to create a prompt. And what is this now? So the prompt is exactly what you will see here when you enter a website. So this is the custom prompt that we created. And when you click allow, you'll be presented with the native prompt. Well, this one is from the browser, so its aspect depends on the browser itself, and it cannot be edited. I will just click allow just for the future. And well, let's go back and let's see how you can create that as well. You can simply click to create custom prompt here. And then you have a name. This name, once again, is only for you. My other prompt is called My Prompt. You can do exactly the same. And well, then here is where you will add the information on what you will be sharing with people that allow these prompts to be displayed what we will be sharing. So some news, promotions, anything that you can think about that you will be offering through web push notifications. And well, you can of course edit this message right here. You can edit the button, so you can do that. You can change the color if you wish. There are many things that you can do, and well, you can then just save and it can be previewed as well, so that I can show you on mobile. And well, then you have the native prompt, as you already, you saw a real example how it looks like, and you can see Firefox like this, Opera, Edge, Chrome. And well, nothing to do about it, you just have to close the preview and then save and activate. As I already have one, I will simply click to cancel. And well, once you click to save and activate, you will see exactly the same as me. And now we have a prompt. So we have a way for people to allow our notifications. So now what we need is a notification itself. And now you will see how many I have here as examples. And well, you would simply click to create a notification. And I will actually pick up from one of mine. So I will just click to duplicate. And well, let's see what we can do. You simply name it. Maybe you just want to call it promotion. And well, then you go straight to the content. And here, well, you can add emojis. You can well, give wings to your imagination here. You can do many things. One of the examples is to promote a specific promotion that will be running on our website, and this way people will be informed on their browser that there is something going on in our page. And well, you can also use that to gather subscribers. You can inform people of certain news or updates, and then the URL here would link them to a form. There are many things that you can do. This is another window, another tool in the shed for your marketing activities. And well, this is our example, self-explanatory. You can add a title, notification text. This icon here you can change. I added my picture here. As you can see, it will look exactly like that, and you can see how it will look on Mac, Android, and well, you can also preview in the browser. And then destination URL, as the name says, this is where people will go when they click on the prompt itself, on the notification in this case. And well, just pay attention when you add the URL, because it needs to follow this format. So HTTPS and then the rest. And here, then you can save the step, and then you can select if you want to send immediately, so it will be sent right now, or schedule for later, self-explanatory, you can select a date and time when you want this notification to be sent to your website visitors. So in this case, it would be to people who already allowed the prompt. And well, in our case, let's just simply send a notification and see how it works. Success. Now we can go to view all notifications. And in a moment, we should receive our notification. Oh, and well, there you see it. As you can see, just another way for you to reach your website visitors, transform them into subscribers. And well, from subscribers, you have another way to turn them into customers. At the end of this video, you will see a button that will take you directly to web push notifications. And well, now this is where I go. I will see you in the next video.